wrong a hero, ladies and gentlemen, with Mike the Spike and his band backing him up as requested. Right now, we're going to have a little bit of a special surprise for everybody.
Okay, here we are rolling.
All right, you take your standard household hookup matches, fold the paper over the top of the match, apply light pressure, with the book's folded right, wiggle the match. Need another match.
Okay,
you take your standard household match, fold the book over like this, press the match onto the flint, and gently wiggle the match. Forget it.
Ed Russell, President, Home Pirate Technics Club for Men.
It's on standby pot long now.
Welcome to Cafe Cabaret. To be here today at the Schizophrenics Convention. It's awful nice to speak to schizophrenics because they always give you their divided attention. This is a song I wrote. It's called I Can Read, I Can Write, I Can Think, I Can Add. And it's about education. I can think, I can write, I can read, I can add. I can think, I can write, I can read, I can add. I can think, I can write, I can read, I can add. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. I can read, I can write, I can think, I can add. I can read, I can write, I can think, I can add. I can read, I can write, I can think, I can write, I can add. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. I can drink, work, eat, sleep. Drink, work, eat, sleep. Drink, work, eat, sleep. Drink, work, eat, sleep. I can read, I can write, I can think, I can add. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. I can drink, I can work, I can eat, I can sleep. That's in the key of A, B, G, and D, of course. I think we can bring up Mr. Michael Labonte. I think you're ready for him. Let's give a big hand, Mr. Michael Labonte.
Some of them want to get you. confused by you. Some of them want to abuse you. Some of them want to be abused. Hold your head up. Keep your head up. Hold your head up. Keep your head up. Hold your head up. Moving on, moving on. Sweet dreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree? I've traveled the world and the seven seas. Everybody's looking for something.
Who wrote the next song? It's called My Funny Valentine.
My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. Your looks are but you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak? Are you smart? But don't change your hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine. Stay. Each day is Valentine's Day.
Next song by Carly Simon.
You walked into the party like you were walking onto a yacht. Your hat strategically dipped below one eye. Your scarf, it was apricot. You had one eye in the mirror as you washed yourself covered, and all the girls dream that they'd be your partner, they'd be your partner, and you're so vain. I bet you think this song is about you. You're so vain. You probably think this song is about you, don't you? Don't you had me several years ago when I was still quite naive, when you said that we made such a pretty pair and that you would never leave. Well, you gave away the things you loved, and one of them was me. I had some dreams, they were clouds in my coffee, clouds in my coffee, and you're so vain. I'll bet you think this song is about you. You're so vain. I bet you think this song is about you. Don't you, don't you? I hear you went up to Saratoga, and your horse naturally won. Then you flew your Learjet up to Nova Scotia to see the total eclipse of the sun. Well, you're where you should be all the time. And when you're not, you're with some underworld spy or the wife of a close friend, wife of a close friend, and you're so vain. I bet you think this song is about you. You're so vain.
Jesus! Jesus is stronger than Satan. He is stronger than Satan. And Satan must be driven out. Satan must be driven out of this room. Satan must be driven out of here. Skip. Now.
I think what the Reverend Hoxie meant to say was kick. So here he is, giving him a hand kicking. Oh, Rich, all right, sorry. Boy, I must have been kicking on that one. This is an old Joe South song. Every night and every day now.
thinking about things that might have been. It's a dirty rotten shame. People walking up to you, singing glory, hallelujah, and they try to talk into you in the name of the Lord. They wanna teach you how to meditate, read your horoscope, cheat your faith, and furthermore.
Still true to me.
tell me, what are you gonna do now? Now that your little world is wasting away, you say you're so damn tired. All the games they want you to play, 'cause where were you yesterday?
Thank you. As you can see, this open mic practically runs itself. That was Richard Lewis, and here's Kit. I think it's customary in these situations to applaud.
What's it like to be?
so great.
I'm working on it.
So is that guy.
Thank you, Michael.
And it hurt me
nothing shows me. And they told me they was gone.
Similar to mine, in fact. I think she performed at T.T. the Bears. How many people here have performed at T.T. the Bears? Well, that's the road that showbiz oblivion. No, only kidding. T.T. is a nice place, and there's a very nice woman. Her name is Patti G. Let's go in. Thank you.
That was Patti G. She loves us and she'll leave us alone. I'm the wrong hero. I hate you. And I'm going to hound you for the rest of your days. How are you? You know I don't care. Why do you even bother confiding your petty humdrum existences to me? This is the sorriest bunch of people who've ever assembled to pay me, the wrong hero, tribute. You better watch it, because I'm the wrong hero. I'm on a destructive quest. I'm in favor of the death penalty. Not because it's cruel, but because it's wrong. I hate unemployment, and I'm going to do something about it. I'm going to get a job. I'm going to be a spokesmodel for the Pentagon. Neutron bombs, computer games, high-tech gadgetry, I'm there. I'm your man, military-industrial complex. I'm making a movie. It's about the war. It's told from the point of view of a smart bomb. One day, the smart bomb gets too smart for its own good. And there's an explosive finale. I'm in favor of death rays. There's lots of nanny panties out there who wear perfumey water under their arms, and they think they're better than everybody else, and they're against death rays. I'm gonna give you 50 reasons why I'm in favor of legalizing death rays. Death rays are found in the tradition of the American citizen death ray wielder. From the time of the founding fathers to the present day, there's nothing like taking a death ray out in your spare time and sapping everything in sight. Death rays are patriotic. Death rays don't discriminate. Death rays kill everything. I feel passionate about the right of every American to own a death ray. A death ray has many uses. Strike breaking, crowd control, defending the country against aliens, defending the country against Washington. You know where all the best whiskey goes? I'll tell you where all the best whiskey goes. It goes plumb straight to hell on the Potomac. That's where it goes. Look at Ted Kennedy. He's got half the nation's boots upon Corral, and he's got a West Palm Beach cargo. Death rays are good because people pay federal taxes on death rays, and that would enrich the economy. Death rays are good to collect because you can look at them and appreciate the evolution of death ray technology. To own a mechanically safe instrument of destruction, go out and buy a death ray and you can't go wrong. Now here's some facts. Fewer than 1% of all violent crimes are committed with death rays. Death rays are useful as a military souvenir of our latest war. Death rays are good so that we can all appreciate the genius of science. Death rays are good to protect yourself against pit bulls, packs of wild pit bulls that roam the empty, deserted streets of our inner cities. A death ray. And your history. Death rays are good to illuminate the city during a blackout. Just aim it right at the armory. You got light enough to fight 3 counties. Death rays are good for healing insect bites. Our founding father said that death rays are a historical necessity to the greatness of our race. And our founding fathers also said death rays are interesting. So what do you say? Legalize death rays or no? Good.
Yeah.
Good, because, you know, if you had said no, well, I got a little surprise for you back there, but I'm not going to take it out just yet. You know who I hate? The Kennedy family.
Yeah.
There is a family that just will not go away. Go away, Kennedys, go away. Quit bothering us with your booziness. You're walking around in your underwear. You're trying to assassinate some of our national leaders. It's all the Kennedys' fault. When the Kennedys, before the Kennedys came around, we were all snug in our bungalows and our bomb shelters. We were revering the military-industrial complex. That slick Massachusetts lawyer from Brookline came along and upset the entire apple cart. And now things have gotten so bad, Oliver Stone is even making a movie about Jack Kennedy. It's not like his name is already on every matchbook in town. Now we have to have a big 2.5-hour-long film spectacle. Gandhi, the sequel. I'm sick of hearing about the Kennedy family. You know what else I'm sick about hearing? free-ranging chicken. I live in an apartment building the size of a telephone booth, and these people are shelling out 15 bucks a pound of free-ranging chicken? What kind of country is this? Is there no justice in this world? And I hate Paul Tsongas. There's one thing you can say about him. He's the only presidential candidate whose nose is big enough to suck a bush in one nostril through pockets when they ever had it. Why does he go away? Why does he wear a cowboy hat? And he's wearing that stupid baseball cap. He looks like a furry troll. What's he going to do? Collect highway tolls when he becomes president? He's going to be the honest administrator, the honest adjudicator. He's going to make the Democrats into the party of Warren G. Harding. I hate Paul Tsongas. Because he's evil. Yeah? You can't put a price tag on the stuff I know. I hate weekends. When I want to loaf, I don't want to do it on a schedule. I hate people who say, tisk, tisk. What is this? What are we, aborigines? Painting our bodies blue, watching the old trees, sitting around in the outback, making fires at a ding-dong dung? Tisk, tisk, a bunch of clicking, illiterate drivers that don't have no written language, they go around going, tisk, tisk, tisk. I hate people go around saying, tisk. I don't want to run for president. I changed my mind. I want to start a political action committee. That's where all the money is. The wrong era political action committee would have as its platform four major steps: death, evil, nervousness, and sacrifice. And the wrong era platform would promote the four basic fears: hunger, loneliness, homelessness, and no microwave popcorn. I hate politicians, I hate the president, I hate all presidents, and people who pretend to be leaders. Do you know why I hate them?
No.
Because they make me nervous. They make me nervous. And you want to know why? Because they're
Scott.
The wrong hero didn't want to stoop to introduce us. Bring this space age looking contraption that's going to pass for guitar, but it's a heck of a lot easier to toss on my back and carry it on the subway than when I go to my corporate job during the day. It looks more like a briefcase than a guitar, so in space age. So Scott and I also play in a band together. It's called Placebo Cool, a.k.a. Is that a bell? Is it too loud? I know of in which Shelley Winters either dies by drowning or dies and then is seen underwater, dead. And, that's an important theme to me. name of one of those movies is Place in the Sun. And we're going to do a song that sort of paraphrases the movie.
Song. Place in the sun. What's that song? What's that, that song?
I don't even sit down. Someone said to me, in a tense situation, you don't love me, you love being in love. I can be anybody.
Thank you.
One more? Okay. Well, let's go ahead and play New Weapons so you can play too. Well, my finger.
Thank you. for Kay and Scott, and thanks.
And I'm Zorro. I'm retired now. I got arrested for putting swastikas on tombstones. I tried to explain to him it was all a misunderstanding that I was Zorro, but anyway, hope you all come back to that big cabaret next week, and this closes the show. Tonight we have Mary Lou Lord, The Virtues, and Dump Truck. Hope to see you next week.
Folky said.